हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस वीडियो इज़ इन कॉन्टिन्यूएशन विद माय प्रीवियस टू वीडियोस ऑन ऑर्डर मार्क एंड शेल्स, वेयर आई शेयर्ड विद यू जनरल करेक्टर, ओरिजन, इवोल्यूशन, फाइलोजेनी एज वेल एज क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ मार्क एंड शेल्स। इन दिस वीडियो आई विल शेयर विद यू स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ गैमेटोफाइट इन द मेंबर्स ऑफ मार्क एंड शेल्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो। Students, you know very well, the thallus in members of Mark and Shale is dichotomously branched, dorsiventral and often with conspicuously prominent lobes, as you can see in this image. Each lobe has an apical notch in which lies the growing point. As you can see in this image, there is a prominent apical notch that encloses the growing point. The dorsal surface of the thallus has polygonal areas called as areolae. Each such area has an air pore in the center. The air pores may be simple or compound in different forms. As you can see here, there is presence of air pore. And you can see dorsal surface contain polygonal areas in the dorsal view. And pore-like structure and these pores are called areolae. Students, from the lower surface, the thallus of all the members bear two kind of appendages, that is rhizoids and scale. Further, the rhizoids are of two types, smooth-walled and tuberculate, as you can see in this image. C is smooth-walled and D is tuberculate. In smooth-walled, wall is smooth, while in tuberculate, peg-like projections appear from the wall to the lumen. You can see clear-cut peg-like projections which appear from the wall to the lumen. And here is smooth-walled rhizoids. The function of rhizoids is anchorage as well as absorption of water. Second is scales. The scales are multicellular plate-like, one cell in thick while purplish in color or structure. As you can see, these are plate-like and multicellular. They may be arranged in one row as in young thallus of Ricea. As you can see, they are present in a single row. They may be present in two rows, one on each side of the midrib. Example are Rabula and Targionia. Or they are present in two to four rows on each side of the midrib as they are present in Markentia. So you can see this is again the identifying or distinguishing feature between different genera. They are irregularly distributed over the entire ventral surface in Coursinia and Athlemia. Students, the scales are further of two types, that is appendiculate and ligulate. And in this image you can see first D1 is the appendiculate scale while E1 is the ligulate. So this is the external as well as internal structure in Mark and Shales. You can see there is prominent midrib, there is notch or apical growing point, polygonal areas are there, air pores are there, and at ventral surface you will find scales as well as rhizoids. Scales are of two type, ligulate and appendiculate, while rhizoids are further tuberculate as well as smooth walled. So that's all about the dorsal thallus or the external structure of the Mark and Shales. Then is internal structure of the thallus. Students, you know very well that it is differentiated into two distinct zones, that is upper green photosynthetic or assimilatory zone, while lower colorless storage zone. Students, the upper and lower epidermis is well differentiated in the thallus, as you can see in this image. Here is upper epidermis while there is lower epidermis, and they are well differentiated. The deep green assimilatory region encloses the air chambers. The chambers are roofed by a single layered epidermis. In the family Ricaceae, the chambers are reduced and are in the form of deep canals or channels. The chambered condition is represented in a rally condition in Dumortieria and is absent in monoselenium. रैली कंडीशन मीन्स हिस्टोरिक बेंचमार्क कंडीशन इन द मार्क एंड शेल्स. इट रिजेंबल विद द प्रिमिटिव जनरा. सो यू विल फाइंड अ रैली कंडीशन इन ड्यूमार्टेरिया स्पीशीज इन विच द चैम्बर्स आर प्रेजेंट. दे मे बी इन वन और मोर देन वन लेयर. ई चैम्बर इज सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम नेबर्स बाय पार्टीशन विच आर जनरली वन सेल थिक. Air chambers may be empty or contain assimilatory filament. When multilayered, the chambers are invariably empty. So you can see here, these are the air chambers. At air chamber, you will find single layered upper epidermis. And each air chamber is separated from other by the partition. And that encloses at upper surface air pores. These pores vary widely in structure in different genera. In Staphanosonila, the pores are simple and wide. They are large and barrel-shaped in Markensia and Persia. In Targigonia, they are semi-barrel-shaped. So again, they are the distinguishing feature between different genera. The ventral zone of the thallus functions as the storage zone. It lies below the air chamber and consists of colorless parenchyma. The parenchyma cells are compactly arranged. They lack chloroplast and contain starch. Here and there are present oil cells. The lowermost layer of this region bear two kind of rhizoids and scales. On the basis of anatomy, Mehra divided the thallus of Markenschales into following three categories. That is Markensia type, Plasiochasma type and Staphanosonila type. First one is Markensia type. The midrib region is expanded. The ventral storage zone is several cells thick. It gradually thin on either side toward the margins where it is 3 or 4 layer thick so that it will form wings as you can see in this image. The midrib region is thick and at wings only 3 or 4 layers are there. The parenchyma cell constituting it are colorless. They contain starch grains. There are oil cells here and there. The lowermost layer bears two kind of rhizoids and scales. The upper assimilatory zone contains air chamber arranged in a single row. So you can see here uppermost region contain air chambers and they are present in single row while the ventral surface bear rhizoids and the scales. The chambers are separated from each other by single layered partition. From the floor of the chamber arises chlorophyllous filament. Each chamber communicates with outside by a barrel-shaped pore as in present the Markensia, and we will go through the details in next slide. Or by a semi-barrel shape in Targigonia. To this category belongs the species of Markensia and Targigonia hypophylla. So you can see or differentiate Markensia with this type of thallus. Here the midrib is prominent or flattened while the wings are narrow. And at ventral surface you find both rhizoids and scales and the air pores are the barrel shape or semi-barrel shape in Targigonia. So students, let's go through the detail in the type genus Markensia. As you know, plant body is thallus and it is differentiated into flattened prostate and dichotomously branched thallus. On the dorsal surface, there is green colored midrib. The midrib wears gamma cup for the asexual reproduction and that is the characteristic feature of the Markensia. The ventral surface consists of unicellular tubular colorless structure called rhizoid and multicellular plate-like violet in color structure are present called scales. Rhizoids absorb water and they are of two types, smooth-walled which are thin, tuberculate which are thick-walled. The scale protect injuries to the thallus and transport water. The scales are simple and complex. Apex of the thallus there is apical notch. The male and female plant are found separately, that means the thallus is dioecious or the species is dioecious. Students, you can see here enlarged view of the thallus in case of Markensia and you can see barrel shaped air pores are present in the upper midrib. This chamber contained photosynthetic filament or lamellae and chambers are separated from each other by single layered partition. So you can see this is a photosynthetic zone, and at the winter surface you will find storage zone, and that consists of colorless parenchyma cell, oil ducts, as well as star cell, mucilage cells and oil cells, and lower epidermis, spheres, rhizoids and scales. So this is the structure in Markentia. Second category is plasiocasmatite. Here the midriff is not much flattened as in case of Markentials. Consequently, the storage region is thickest in the center. In the wing, it consists of a single layer of cell which represent the lower epidermis. So here you will find single layer, while in Markentials 3 to 4 cells may be there. The asymmetry zone consists of air chambers arranged in several layers, while in Markentia they are present in single layer. The chambers are empty and are separated by the single layered partition. So here you can see multi-serrate air chambers. The air pores are either star shaped or semi-barrel shaped. The next or second category is plasiocasma type. The midriff is not much flattened in this case. Consequently, the storage region is thickest in the center, and in the wings it consists of a single layer of cell which represent the lower epidermis. So at the wings you will find only single layered cells. You can see here only a single layer is there, and that represent only the lower epidermis. The assimilatory zone consists of air chamber arranged in several layer one above the other, as you can see in this image. So you can differentiate it from Markentia type, which contain a single layered air chamber, while here you will find multi-layered chamber. The chambers are empty and are separated by single layered partition. In case of Markentia type, you find there photosynthetic lamellae are present in the chamber, while here chambers are empty. The air pores are either star shape or semi barrel shape. And example in this case are plasiocasma appendiculatum, plasiocasma articulatum, rebulia, hemispherica, astrelia, mucerensis, grimaldia indica and athlemia pinguensis. Students, this is the internal structure in case of plasiocasma. You can see here two types of smooth walled and tuberculate rhizoids, and you will find here star shape or semi barrel shape air pores, and the chambers are empty as well as multi layered. You can see here complete thallus. Above is photosynthetic zone with multi layered air chambers, but the air chambers are empty unlike the Markentia. And you can see air pores, they are either star shape or they are barrel shape. And at the winter surface you again find scales and the rhizoids. Third and last category is Stephanosonilla type. The midriff is least expanded, and the winter storage region consists of colorless cell which contains starch or protein granules. The wings on either side consist of lower epidermis and a layer of air chamber above it. So you can find here lower epidermis, and that contain air chamber above. The chambers are spacious and empty. You can compare that they are multi-layered in the second category, that is plasiocasma type, and they are single layered in case of Markentia type, while here they are spacious and empty. They communicate with the exterior through large gaps or pores of extremely primitive type. See here pores or the gap. To this category belongs Stephanosonilla, Brevipenduculata, Sochia spongiosa, Astrella blumenia, Astrella reticulata, Ricea crystalliana and Cryptometrium himalensis. So you can see this type of thallus in dorsal view here. You can see rosti like condition is present in the Ricea. apical notch is there, a prominent midrib is present on the dorsal surface, while rhizoid and scales are there. You can see scales are present at the margins of the lobe and they are of single type, that is ligulate type, while rhizoids are of both types, that is tuberculate and smooth walled. You can see here reproductive internal structure of Ricea thallus, and at the dorsal surface there are air pores, air chambers. Air chambers are spacious and followed by a prominent assimilatory zone. Unlike the Markensia, where storage zone is prominent. And you can see at the bentous surface, scales and rhizoids are there, but scales are of the simple type and usually present at the margins of the thallus, as you can see in this image. They are only ligulate type. So students, that's all about the internal structure in members of the Markensia. I hope you understood this topic. Thank you for listening.